What is going on, guys? Welcome back to their vlog. Today is really exciting because Christian has a very special moment at school. Are you tired? He looks so adorable. I'll show you guys when we get to his school. He has like a full little tuxedo outfit on. He has a choir recital tonight, but it's not like real choir, I guess. There's no like after school practices or anything. It's just like songs that the kids have been learning all year because they're about to get out for summer. So they're doing a recital tonight for all the parents, and the teachers told us to bring tissues because there's a song they specifically wrote for their moms, and I'm sure I'm gonna tear up. He just looks so old and so grown. He literally has a full like tux outfit on with a little tie and like a bow tie, and the pants are super cute. They said to wear a button up, but they didn't say to go like all out, but you know I did. We just pulled up outside the school. There's a huge line of cars. It's probably gonna take us like 15 minutes to get in there. So yeah, I'm really excited. It's super cute. Christian's done like soccer or basketball, stuff like that, but he's never done like choir or band. And I don't know, I'm really proud of him. His like memory retention is not always so great. He's always been a little behind with his learning. So the fact that he's been able to memorize so many songs and he's just been so excited for this is so like cute and exciting for me. I'm just so proud of him. And this is one of the moments where I just love having a YouTube channel. This is the very first reason I ever started years and years ago, was to literally just document for ourselves the journey of him growing up, me being a single mom, like milestones we had. And then, you know, over time it grew to where people wanted to follow us and watch. But these are the memories that I really just love having for ourselves. So I'm very excited you guys get to share in this moment with us tonight. Give the video a like for Christian and for his effort and for his cute little outfit and just, you know, because he's the babe and we are so proud of him. So yeah, we'll see you guys in there.
Oh my God. Look at this fit though. You want to hit him with a spin? A little OOTD? You look so grown. Oh my God, I'm so excited.
Surgery.
Is she gonna be okay? You're literally such a good brother. We walked in there and Christian just started crying. Hi, Mama. So.
And there's a rip in here.
It's okay. Sadie had to get surgery on her paw. Aw, poor baby. She has so many medications to take. She's probably still coming out of the sedation a little bit. Oh my gosh. I want to get her home right away, babe, because we got to feed her a bland diet and give her her meds so she can relax a little. And then we'll get home and we'll tell everyone what happened, okay? Thanks for coming with me today, bud. I love you. She's going to be okay. Aw, baby girl. So we just got home. She's still coming out of some sedation. Oh my gosh, I'm having a total flashback right now because I filmed a video like this when she got spayed and we brought her home and she had the cone. And if you guys watched that video, Christian started bawling his eyes out because he was so scared seeing her like this. Oh my God, sweetheart. So I think I have to go ahead and take off this bandage. That's where they like put the catheter in. But this is the paw that had the huge issue. Basically, they had to cut open her entire paw and there was a mass that grew there and they're gonna send it out for biopsy. Aw, thank you, bud. You're an excellent brother.
Good morning, you guys. It is, I think, almost 10 a.m. I just took a shower, threw some curls in my hair. I'm gonna do like super minimal makeup today, so I figured I would continue on the vlog. I kind of wanted to branch off the clips that you guys, I think the clips that you just saw, I'm not sure how I'm gonna structure the vlog, but I mentioned a little bit what happened to Sadie, and I kind of just wanted to go in a little bit more detail and let you guys know. Yeah.
foundation. The lighting in here is not great because there's a huge window behind me. Kind of just let you guys know what ended up happening to her and why we had to take her in for emergency surgery. And I'm so glad we took her in at the same time that we did, so nothing spread. But basically I ended up finding a mass, like a bump. I didn't know it was like a mass, right here in between her paw. It was risen and it was red and it was kind of scabbing on the side. And my friend Nicole told me it may be a heat pad or a hot pad, I think it's called, with dogs where they lick too much in that area or it gets irritated. So she told me to go ahead and just like put some cream on it and just keep an eye on it, which I did the previous night after I found it. But the next day, something was just like lurking like in my gut, telling me I really need to take her in and it's just something not normal. And you know what they say, nothing will ever cost you more than ignoring your intuition. That gut feeling that you have about something, like 99% of the time, especially I know with me, like from past experience, is always right. So I was like, oh, let me just take her in. So the second night I ended up taking her in, it was like 8 p.m. I do pay for pet insurance at a different place. I need to start doing my makeup. I always go off on tangents. But that place wasn't open, and there's one other vet hospital by my house, but I called ahead and they had a really long wait because I had Christian. My mom didn't, I asked her if she could kind of help out with Christian while I took Sadie in for this, but she was busy that night. So I took him in with me. It was already pretty late at night and I knew he would be not irritated, but I just wanted to call ahead and see if there was like a crazy wait time. But we ended up taking Sadie in and they told me, the lady examined the mass, or like the bump in between her paw, and they told me that they would need to take her in the back and sedate her because Sadie is a super, super, super hyper, like active dog. They couldn't really hold her down enough to like fully like spread open the paw right here and like really look at it. She was squirming like crazy. So they took her in the back. They're like, hey, we might have to give her some mild sedation to like really calm her down so we can look up in there and see what it is. And I was like, okay. So they had a few other dogs ahead of us in line, but we ended up waiting maybe like an hour. They came back and said they think it would be best if I leave Sadie overnight, and they cut open her paw right there and see if it's a cancerous mass or like what it could be, if there was an infection inside, if maybe another animal or insect outside or at the park maybe bit her. So immediately I thought they would maybe put, like, I know this might sound weird, but I thought they could give her a shot right there in between her paw and like it would take down the swelling, or I thought they could somehow like examine it or do an x-ray and see if there was anything inside that was like a bacterial infection. Like, I didn't know they were trying to like cut open her paw. So anyways, we ended up leaving her overnight, and they did surgery that same night. Christian and I went home. They told us go home, sleep, get some rest, and that they were gonna cut open her paw right here. And they ended up cutting all the way into her arm right here as well, because they wanted to see if the mass had grown. If it was cancer, it could like spread to other parts of the body. So needless to say, Christian and I were not expecting that at all, and we were kind of freaking out because she is so young. She's not even a year old yet. So in my mind, I'm like, how can a year old puppy like get cancer? And I asked the lady, and I don't mean for it to sound like a dumb, naive question, but I was like, is this genetic? Like, is it just something that grows? And she said, just like with humans, you know, with certain cancers, it's just something that grows out of nowhere, a foreign mass in the body, and it could be benign, but they had no idea. They're gonna literally take what they cut out and send it off to a different lab that they work with, and they would call me within 5 to 7 days for the results. So if you know me in person, you know Sadie is literally my daughter. I'm one of those crazy dog moms where I am so attached to her. I love her more than anything. The fact that that was even a possibility had me super scared and like worried, to be honest. And I posted a little Insta story that we were at the vet, and so many of you reached out and sent me messages that you were praying for her and that you cared and just that you hoped she was okay. And I just wanna let you know that means more than you guys know. I fell asleep that night just uneasy, like waiting for the doctor's call back and worried, and like, I know it sounds corny because you're like internet friends, but like, I appreciate you guys so much, and reading through all your messages like literally got me through that night. Christian's so young, he didn't really understand what was happening. I mean, he understood that she had to get surgery because I told him, but apart from that, he didn't really understand like the gravity of it. And once again, I know law of attraction, what we say in our mind and what we speak out loud is what appears into our reality. So I didn't come home and say like, it's cancer, and like freak myself out and invite that reality like into my existence. I didn't do that. I had it in my mind, like the doctor told me, she's like, she's young, there's no reason for her to have grown like a cancerous mass at this age, but it is possible. So once again, we're just gonna have to see what we find, how far it's spread, and we'll call you. And I was like, okay. So we ended up getting home like probably right before midnight. They called me at like 3 a.m. and told me that they cut out the mass. Luckily it did not spread further down here into her arm. But she did have like 4 staples in between her paw, which she still has right now. We have to take her next Friday to get them taken out. And they said they will send off the mass to the lab that they work with. which they ended up doing. By the time I'm putting up this vlog, this is like over a week and a half later, so I've already gotten the call back from the lab. It was not cancer, thank God. But it was, I forget what it was called, a certain type of mass that can literally just grow out of nowhere in animals. I can put the name of it down below if I forget. Of course, the minute I record the video, I forget what it's called. But they said just keep an eye on all her other paws and any areas of her body. If anything like that were to grow, come in right away, like it needs to get cut out. So it was definitely a big ordeal. Like I thought I was gonna go in there and they were gonna be able to drain like the pus out and we would leave. I had no idea it would require that type of surgery. So I'm just very thankful that we had really good doctors. I had never actually been to that vet hospital. It's pretty close to my house, but I've never had to go in before, obviously because she's my first pet and I haven't, she hadn't had any like emergency before this, but I'm really thankful for the doctors that were there that night and how they helped her, but it's definitely scary leaving her there. I had to sign a paper saying that some dogs just don't respond well to the sedation, and if she happens to not respond or her, or she like stops breathing, do I want them to give her CPR? Like I had to sign all these forms that like nothing is ever guaranteed in medical, and that like your puppy, there's a possibility they could pass away. It's pretty scary like leaving your dog there and not knowing the reality of what it's gonna be the next morning. Not to scare anyone, but it's definitely, I don't know, it's scary, man. So I'm just really thankful that she's okay now. She's walking around the house, she's fine. She is, what was I saying? I can never talk and do this. She's good, she's walking around the house now. She's just kind of like laying low. She's eating a super bland like chicken and rice diet, as you guys know, for the next like 2 weeks. And she has a few medications that she's on for pain, for swelling, and she's gonna be okay. Very, very thankful that it was not anything like worse. But it was definitely like an unexpected experience, and I'm just very happy that I listened to my intuition and my gut and like took her in when I did. Because if not, I'm not sure if it could have, you know, grown or caused her more pain or etc. This is super off topic, but I have been loving lately, you can't really tell in this lighting, it's really bad, but I've been loving setting my foundation with these little old ass sponges. Like I feel like this is super OG with makeup, but whenever I set it with a brush, I get a bunch of lines, and with this it's like, I don't know, it gives you such a matte like clear finish. I'll bring you guys out into the daylight when we're done. But yeah, Sadie is really, really good. Just wanted to update you guys. Literally so many of you reached out, like I was blown away. So thank you so, so much. It just means a lot to me that you guys would care. Anytime anything happens with her or with Christian, you guys are real quick to hop in the DMs and just say you're praying for me or you're there for me. And once again, I know I'm a broken record, but I really feel that I have an engaged, genuine, just supportive audience who really, really cares. And that's just like, it's incredible. So thank you guys, you're amazing. But yeah, she is doing good. I am not sure what you guys have watched so far in this vlog, because I don't know where I'm gonna insert this clip. I think this vlog is like a mashup of everything, but tonight we are gonna go to Home Goods. Oh God, oops. Home Goods and Marshall's later after Christian does a quick little rest, because he's exhausted, he had a play date earlier. But I'm going to redo my room. In my one of my last videos, I showed you guys some house updates, but I can't do anything like permanent to the house because I don't own this house yet. So I'm trying to find ways to like spruce up the rooms and stuff without like nailing too much stuff into the wall or doing anything that's like more permanent. I am renting this house, as you guys know, from a military family, and I have not heard back. Oh, I can't do this and talk. If they're coming back or like what their deal is. So I can't really do anything too permanent. And it's kind of annoying me lately. Like I thought it'd be cool to just rent this house because my mom lived nearby, which that's all changing too. I'll share that maybe in another vlog. And I was like, it's definitely been a really good experience, right? Like I've never had a house before. So for me to have my own house, to be here, to handle all the maintenance, to do everything by myself has been a huge learning experience. And it's definitely a good first home for me, but I'm really happy I didn't buy this house because I'm not sure where I want to settle. Most of my family lives north. And I don't want to like buy a home and then be alone in this town. You know, I want to find a home that I can buy where Christian can grow up and we can stop moving. I don't even like moving. Every time my apartment lease has been up, I've kind of got something different or I've moved for Christian's school, but I'm so ready to just own a property, do all the decor and like home improvements that I want to do and just keep him in one home so he can grow up and have like just one home, you know? So, yeah, I don't want to get too much into that in this video, but I may start house hunting soon for a property to purchase. And yeah, that's a whole nother like topic shebang. So anywho, I think I'm gonna leave my makeup like this today. I'm gonna do a tiny bit of mascara, but I don't know where it is.
Okay, it's almost 7:10 p.m. We are heading out for date night. If you've been watching my vlogs a while, obviously since I have Christian every day, we can do date night or like spend one-on-one quality time together a lot, which I'm very thankful for, but we do still like to have, let me set you guys down, a designated date night. Sorry if the lighting is a bit dark. It's been super gloomy today, like actually rainy. But Christian, tell him where are we going for date night? It was your choice. Bowling, yeah. So I'm excited. It is Memorial weekend, but I feel like a lot of people are out on the lake at Havasu, Vegas, etc. So it might be like really empty in there. Hopefully we can get a lane without waiting and we can just get right in there. I think we're gonna play like two games.
Guys, I'm so excited to go bowling and it's my favorite thing.
It's your favorite thing? You're my favorite thing.
I'm your favorite thing.
Cutie pie. All right, let's go.